All right, low waste versus plastic free versus minimalism versus, it's not really a versus. These are kind of all encompassing terms, and we really throw them around without necessarily defining them. And we kind of assume that people know what we mean when we say them, but we also kind of say them carelessly, and maybe they're not exactly what we mean. They're just the terms that we use in our lives.
Well, then what do you mean?
All right, so what I think, the way that we kind of use things is, I would describe us as low waste. Would you describe us as low waste?
I'd maybe say low waste, low impact. Can I group them together? Low waste, low impact?
Maybe, but let me explain to you why I would say that's encompassed in low waste.
Let's hear it.
Because I think that within low waste, we are trying to waste as little as possible. And that means everything. That's not just we'll produce less trash, we won't have food waste at the end of a meal. It also means that we are not wasting our time. We are not wasting energy of ourselves as well as our car or lights or having everything plugged in. Therefore, I would call that, it ends up being low impact. But because low impact is often used in sports, I probably wouldn't use it here just because it's gonna conflate things and throw people off from what we're talking about. So I would say that we are low waste. We try to produce no trash. We are not 100% successful at producing zero, which now you get closer to people who are living a zero waste lifestyle. And those people, I would say, are just really farther along their journey than us, or they're living a life that is different from us. Like, we are still using a lot of items that we have already owned. I'm holding a pen in my hand. It is made of plastic. We bought this in Mexico. And one day I will have a fountain pen, but that day is not going to come for a little while longer because there's still an inch of ink left in this pen. And it's not going to be a zero waste, but it's going to be low waste because I'm going to use the whole pen and then I'm going to replace it with a more conscious alternative.
After disposing of it correctly?
I'll have to do some research, but disposing of a pen correctly is probably throwing it in landfill. Correct. Because there is not a very responsible option for every item. And this is different from plastic free.
The reason I'd want to encompass low impact is because of the fact that we don't just look at our environmental impact, we look at our ethical impact. So like we've said before, when we're looking at companies to replace things that we need to replace, we also look at, you know, are there employees getting fair wages, living wages? Are there employees being treated like humans and not just employees or robots or anything like that, slaves? So I think having a low impact is low waste. Having a low impact is a lower carbon footprint. Having a low impact is, you know,
being considerate of the impact on humans, other humans.
Humans and the environment, yeah.
Humans, the environment, animals. Those are kind of the biggies.
Mm-hmm.
Plastic free is a little bit different. Plastic free kind of brings in, I think, when using that term, you're bringing in a level of talking about plastic interactions with the environment and with your body. And this brings in a whole extra level of toxicity. And this is something that we think about for sure, but I wouldn't say that we are plastic free because we do still use Tupperware. We have Tupperware. This is low waste. We can't replace all of our Tupperware with glass because we still have Tupperware. And we are maybe not as concerned yet about the toxicity that comes along with things like a very durable plastic like Tupperware. Like, we know not to microwave things in our plastic Tupperware. We know not to expose it to heat, not to continue to use it for food if it is degrading by any means. However, we could still use the Tupperware to store other items, whether it's just, I don't know, what do people store things? Buttons? My grandmother keeps a whole lot of buttons. Maybe we can keep buttons in our Tupperware. Things that we're not
gonna... We don't collect that many buttons in our life.
I learned to count and I learned my colors with those buttons, so be careful. We're gonna have a lot of buttons in case anyone else needs to learn to count. So we're not plastic free.
Yeah, the other thing with plastic free is, you know, when we visit family, when we visit friends, we're gonna, you know, eat stuff out of their fridge that's maybe containing plastic. We're gonna eat all their stuff.
Because we're low waste, so we're gonna eat anything that's going bad. Anything. I just did that today. We're staying at my mom's house. I just removed everything from the fridge that really has past its prime, just so that we can get through it today, because otherwise it becomes food waste and we are low waste.
And low waste encompasses food waste.
Mm-hmm. So while all these terms are very similar, and they have a ton of overlaps, you know, minimalist obviously is going to come into there. And I would say that we are minimalist. One of the difficulties with talking about all of the swaps or providing information about different swaps you can make for products, you know, for your clothes, for the things that you're doing, is that, like, we don't buy stuff. We really don't. I cannot tell you, like, what companies make the best products that are chemical-free, cruelty-free, and this and that. It's like, if I need new chapstick, I'm going to make it because I'm not trying to
acquire new things.
So minimalism definitely gets thrown in there. The reason I would like to get more specific in our terminology and explain our terminology is that when it's just the two of us or people in our circle, people who are living the same lifestyle as we are, it's pretty easy to throw around terms because you know each other, you know what you mean, even if you're not saying what you mean. But if you're new on this journey, if you're new to this lifestyle, if you're trying to learn, then it probably causes confusion. Or if you disagree with this lifestyle, it's really easy to pick apart the terms that people use. So getting on the same page about the terms that we use is going to be important going out, and we want to try to help clarify the way that we perceive the terms that we are using, the way that we're seeing them out in the world, the differences with what we're seeing. So while I would like to categorize this as one specific thing, which I would have said was low waste, but I think Jackie makes a really good point at being low impact, and I think it's also notable that we really aim for minimalism. You can be all of these things. You can be striving for all of these things. You could be informed about all of these things. And while they have their differences, it's more important to recognize that they all have their similarities and their overlaps. And, you know, the more you know, then your little sphere of concern is growing and growing and growing. And you develop new habits, you develop a new mindset, and you grow. And this is a process of growth, and we have more to grow, and there's no end goal in sight. There's no, once we hit this mark, we've made it. You know, there will always be more to learn. There will always be more changes that we can make. And sometimes maybe it's backpedaling. Sometimes we move in a different direction. We pivot and we remain flexible. We acquire as much knowledge as we can. And then once we have that knowledge, we make the changes that we see as being the responsible things to do for ourselves, for our lives, for the planet, for others, for animals.
Well said.
Thank you.